Here's what's left of my elderberry. Those Japanese beetles have demolished it. Next one possible to get it, to stay, keep them off. There's a male and a female. Now this other one's got flowers. Before it was just this one. But the beetles got all over this thing. And you can see how bare they look and how stripped they are. You know, I'm not putting any toxic poison on here. I'd rather just keep trying to ward them off with dishwashing liquid and water. That's a natural insect. See, look right here, look at these. Look at this. You see them? I can't squash them out here. I can just knock them off the plant. But I take a quart spray bottle with a tablespoon of dishwashing liquid. They say Dawn, but I just use dishwashing liquid, you know. It does the same thing. One tablespoon of dishwashing liquid to a quart bottle of water and just spray them. It doesn't harm the plant and it kills off the insects. And it's still, but right now with this heat right now, it's hard to do. I have to do it early in the morning or in the evening. The sun goes down there and the west used to be directly that way. Now it seems to be that way ever since 2011. Except March 11, 2011 when Fukushima happened. And the earth knocked off its axis. Instead of setting back there, now the sun sets it that way. So, tell me I'm crazy. You gotta go check it out sometime. And you'll see how stupid you might look. But, yeah. This one is looking better.
Cross-pollinated.
Yeah.
There's the black beauty.
Black beauty, green
there's
one.
There's the yellow.
And the yellow one, yeah. Wow, they're still there, like 8 feet away. But, yeah.
I was looking at that, I thought, what the heck? Yeah, that's what's happening.
Yeah, but see all this grass. This is, again, next year I don't know what the hell to do except just plant in the sun. You know, well, not this, but I thought the okra would go over in number two next year and just hopefully it'll grow, you know, just plant a bunch of them. Because as long as you have 10 okra plants, you have more than enough okra. Right now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
There is actually another, this is actually a separate one, but it ain't growing more shit because it's over here in the grass.
Yeah.
It's pulling that out of there.
That's why I plant others where that stake is right there. I planted like two seeds back where those two stakes are, tomato stakes are, I put two in the back corner there.
I think it's on the plastic, that's why it's not going on any further. Roots.
Uh-huh.
That's why it's not growing much bigger.
I mean, it's really, about the end of this week, and maybe get them by August, we'll have some if we plant a couple more out in this area. Yeah, these are waist high, almost chest high. Oh yeah, look at our tomato plant coming out of our compost bin. Bought this at Aldi's.
We got flowers starting.
Five or six, about a year ago, last year. And just compost inside there, and there's a tomato plant growing out of the compost.
Let it grow.
Yeah, I know, you can't. And I gotta pull it out, it's coming through them little lines, you see. Right there, coming out down there. If we get tomatoes off this, that'd be so cool.
That'd be awesome.
And we have a tomato over here start growing. Evidently something got dropped, a seed or two, like a seed. And I put a fencing around it. We had that little cheap, oh, I gotta do this, air conditioner. This thing around it, I don't like these. So I, this homemade one, I put around it. And stuck it down the ground with the tomato stake in the middle here, this green one. That's a tomato plant. So, and then we got lettuce.
From, but it's
okay, you're gonna have to.